together. It irritates me. What's interesting is I'm guilty of the same crime. Because I went and got somebody's two-bar hook, threw some drums over it, and called it my own. Now, part of that's ignorance. Other part of that is innovative as fuck. I'm sorry, can I say fuck? Is that all right? You can. I can say fucking hell. It was really innovative. And to be able to stop a track in the middle of it going like that, leave one little note, boom, like that, and have people going crazy whenever you heard that out or you played it. And what went along with this was finally a chance to go out, went out and heard these things. Lil Lewis playing them, heard Ron Hardy playing them, heard all these different guys playing them. And it was just shocking walking to a spot and see the whole crowd react and call and response to the person playing it back and forth. And I was just like, oh my God, this is amazing. Now, when I hit the floor, it was because I wanted to dance, because that's what this music was about. It was about moving. And it was no, how do I explain this? If you take away the magazines from dance music, if you can imagine what's left, if you go back in time, if you take that away, you take away all of the sponsorship, you take away all of the things that make it a commodity, and you break it down to its essential form, you have nothing but pure experience among individuals.